series of sweeping victories for same-sex marriage supporters in the span of less than 1 week. Two states, Iowa and Vermont, have legalized gay marriage, and Washington, D.C. officials have voted to recognize same-sex marriages performed elsewhere. We turn now to CNN's Alina Cho. She is working this story for us. Alina, what is the significance of these developments we're hearing about?
Hey, Don, good afternoon. You know, you really have to look at what happened in Vermont. Now, remember, this is the state that invented civil unions back in 2002, and now Vermont is making news again as the first state in the nation to legalize same-sex marriage by a vote in the legislature, not a court ruling, and that is key. Now, there are currently four states that allow gay marriage: Vermont, Iowa, Connecticut, and Massachusetts. Four other states currently have bills before lawmakers to allow same-sex marriage right now, and they are New Hampshire, Maine, New York, and New Jersey. So how do Americans feel about this? Well, pretty evenly split. No surprise there. A CNN opinion research poll out in December showed that 55% of Americans believe that gay marriage should not be recognized by law as valid. 44% say yes, it should be recognized. Now, the vote in Washington is interesting because if approved, that measure would then be sent to Congress for a legislative review and a vote. Now, that's because Washington, as many people know, not a state, a district, so its bills must pass through Congress, and that could make for a very interesting showdown on a national stage. So where does the president stand on this? Well, Don, President Obama says he does support civil unions, but not same-sex marriage. Don?
All right, Alina Cho, we appreciate it. Thank you very much for that. I'm going to take this topic really in depth right now. And for that, we are joined by CNN senior political analyst Jeffrey Toobin, Lara Schwartz of the Human Rights Campaign, and Kerry Gordon Earle of Focus on the Family. Hope you guys are all doing well this evening, well enough to join us here in the Situation Room. Jeffrey, I'm going to start with you because we're talking about D.C., and Alina brought that up. D.C. has now voted to allow gay couples married in other states to be recognized in D.C. Could this mean other states will follow? So, you know, as D.C. goes, so will the rest of the country?
I don't think other states are going to say, well, D.C. did it, we need to do it too. But in each state, there is a movement in favor of gay marriage. In some states, it's pretty clear, like New Jersey, gay marriage is clearly going to arrive. In some states, through much of the South, gay marriage is not going to arrive. And I think we're approaching a real federalist solution here. Gay marriage is going to exist in some states and not in others. And that's probably an acceptable compromise for at least most people.
A federalist solution, Kerry, when you see this happening in states, and many people thought that they would never see it happen, when you have an economy that's struggling, people are concerned about losing their jobs and paying for their homes, even losing their homes, is it hard to get people to support the issue, this issue, when they have what they might deem bigger issues to deal with?
Oh, absolutely not. I mean, the people who are tuned into this issue, Don, are fired up. And you saw that in November when you had three states, two really big ones, Florida and California and Arizona, passing marriage amendments that said marriage was between a man and a woman. People in these states and across the nation sacrificed time and a lot of money. I mean, if you look at the money that was raised, so most certainly this is an issue in the heartland and across the country. People know that in the 30 states, in the 30 times people were allowed to vote on this issue, they overwhelmingly voted for marriage. And by the way, the Vermont legislature could have let their people vote and they refused to do so.
Well, I hear what you're saying, but again, and I'm gonna turn now to Lara to talk about this. I mean, Lara, do you think that usually social issues are sometimes put on the back burner? And now with the economy and with, you know, huge things happening overseas, people may not be turning to those now, and social issues may be the ones that they turn to because they feel that they can make a difference. Are you finding that the economy or this environment is helping you at all?
You know, the economy is affecting all American families in such profound ways. And for gay and lesbian families, you know, there's a risk in most states in this country that you can be fired because you're gay or transgender. If you lose your job, you don't benefit from the new subsidized COBRA that has just been passed. You pay into Social Security equally, but don't get that safety net from those family benefits.
So because people are so focused on that, on those economic issues, that they have become even more dogged about getting what they think they're owed.
Well, I think what we're learning from this economy is that we're all facing this, and I think to an extent people know that other people trying to commit and raise their families is not the biggest threat to them when there's foreclosure and job loss. But at the same time, it's really teaching us how much all of our families have in common. which is just far outweighs our differences. And that's why the Vermont legislature could very proudly, in light of day, pass a law that says all families are equal. They're all struggling equally, they're all committed equally, and now they're going to be equal under law.
And Jeffrey, I'm hearing that this is something that could just be decided about what you decide marriage is or what you decide a civil union is, and you know, and what how much rights someone should get. It may come down to a compromise on what the actual name is. Rather than marriage, they may want to call it something else.
You know what? I don't think it's going to come down to a compromise. This is really about marriage and the whole bundle of rights that comes with marriage. And a lot of gay people have said, look, you can call civil union whatever you want, but it treats us as second-class citizens not to have the same rights and the same name as marriage. But just in terms of one thing about this issue that I think is so interesting, it is true that more than a majority of Americans don't support gay marriage, but the demographics are really striking. Young people support it, older people oppose it, and I think that argues for change in the direction of pro-gay marriage as young people get older.
Probably sooner than we think. Jeffrey Toobin, our senior legal analyst, Lara Schwartz of the Human Rights Campaign, and Carrie Gordon Earle with Focus on the Family. Thank you all very much. We appreciate your time here in the Situation Room.